and services designated in LEXIS or COMPANY. Today we'll discuss the general principles of the POCSO Act. There are a few principles which are to be followed while the conduct of a trial under the POCSO Act. Today we'll discuss those principles. First principle is right to be treated with dignity. Various provisions under the POCSO Act reflect that it is very crucial to treat a child with dignity and utmost compassion. Second, right to life and survival. Right to life is a fundamental right provided under Article 21 of the Indian Constitution. It is essential that a child should be protected from the evils of the society and could be brought up in a secured environment. Thirdly, right against discrimination. This is also a crucial fundamental right and an additional duty under the Indian Constitution. A child should not be discriminated against on the basis of sex, religion, culture, etc. Investigative and court procedures should be just and fair. Fourth, right to preventive measures. Children being immature in their growing stages should be well trained so that they become capable of preventing abuses against them, thereby differentiating between what is right and what is wrong. Fourth, fifthly, right to be informed. A child should be informed of the legal procedures that are being carried out for the conviction of the accused. Lastly, the right to privacy. The main objective behind provisions like Section 3 is to protect the right to privacy of children against whom any offence under the POCSO Act has been committed so as to maintain the confidentiality of the proceeding for the best interest of the child victim. Thank you, and if there is any doubt, please mention that in the comment section.